Hey, what up, you guys? This is Danny B. You're watching The Trash Dish, and in this video, I'm going to be reviewing The Warriors.
Maybe we better take off.
Yeah, right.
Now, I have this movie on DVD somewhere, and I'll just splice in a video. I don't know where it is right now, but I was kind of looking all over trying to find it. When I do find it, I'll just put in a little video of it. I don't know what you call it. It's not exactly an action film, but it's definitely like one that has action scenes in it. What would you call this? Maybe a sci-fi movie? Kind of like a sci-fi sci-fi movie, I don't know, kind of like a post-apocalyptic gang movie, I guess, set in New York in the 70s, maybe? But yeah, this movie's a lot of fun. It's got great characters, cool, like, scenes of the radio DJ announcing everything that the Warriors are doing. It's a gang turf movie, that's what you call it. And, you know, a lot of, like, graffiti artists love this movie. Definitely has, like, that 80s graffiti kind of vibe going on. And actually, this is partially a true story. I was watching some documentary, I can't remember the name of it, but it turns out that gangs in New York back in the 70s were actually kind of like this, and the big meeting scene in the beginning is actually based on a true event where this guy was trying to get all the gangs together, and then he got shot right in front of everyone. But yeah, I saw this movie back when I was in high school, and I definitely like it. It's kind of like, if you like Escape from New York or any of those kind of like post-apocalyptic type of movies, you'd probably like it. And now let's get into the plot, and this will not contain spoilers. So the Warriors show up to this big gang meeting. This guy's trying to bring peace and like get all the gangs to join together to make like one giant gang to run the city. And everyone's kind of going along with it. But there's one guy in the crowd, or maybe it's the whole gang in on it, I don't know, but the guy pulls a gun and shoots the gang leader. And the gang leader looks exactly like The Rock. He looks like the 70s version of the wrestler, The Rock. And he's going up there going, "We're gonna get everyone together. Can you dig it?"
60,000 soldiers. Now, there ain't but 20,000 police in the whole town. Can you dig it? Can you dig it? Can you dig it?
So he gets shot, and he gets shot by the guy that's, he looks like Sean Penn, but it's this guy that's in, like, Twin Peaks and a bunch of other action movies. A good actor. I don't know his name, though. He shoots the gang leader. One of the Warriors witnesses it. So then he turns the gun around on the Warrior guy, but the Warrior guy gets away, and now it looks like the Warriors killed the guy. So now the Warriors are trying to get back to Coney Island, and they have to cross paths with every other gang, the Baseball Furies, the Cross-Eyed Guy, I don't know his name, but all these other gangs, they have to fight and battle on their way home. And not to mention the police, too. And there's Ajax, which is probably my favorite of the Warriors. There's Cochise. There's the little guy, I can't remember their names really. And then there's the girl who was part of a different gang, but she ends up going with the Warriors. So they're kind of sneaking around New York, trying to get back home. And there's this radio DJ lady, and she keeps announcing every couple seconds that the Warriors are in for their doom and stuff like that. She's like announcing every fight that happens, like the Baseball Furies drop the ball and stuff like that.
All right, now, for all you bumpers out there in the big city, all you street people with an ear for the action, I've been asked to relay a request from the Gramercy Riffs. It's a special for the Warriors. That's that real live bunch from Coney, and I do mean the Warriors. Here's a hit with them in mind.
One by one, the Warriors are kind of slipping up, getting caught, getting killed, stuff like that. And then there's this other gang. I forget what their name is, but they're like a karate gang. And the guy, the way he talks always makes me laugh. He talks with his entire mouth.
Like, I want them all. I want all the warriors. I want them alive if possible, if not wasted.
And then they cross paths with this gang led by this like skinny cross-eyed guy. This guy is not really a tough guy, and he agrees to let the warriors pass through his neighborhood, but then like he wants them to take their jacket off or something like that, and they're not willing to do that. They're like, fuck you, we'll just take over your shit if you want us to do that. Then his gang gets the shit beat out of him.
I'll tell you, the man you are.
Take your colors off, you can walk through.
We don't do that.
It's just our mark, it don't mean we're at war.
You go as civilians, okay? You go as soldiers, I gotta come down on you. Now take off your colors. Can you hear me?
Fuck you.
The guy's girlfriend ends up going with them, the Warriors. There's also the Baseball Furies. They're like these cool baseball players with like half their face painted. And the music in this is awesome too. It's like... Now my favorite character in this is actually the villain. The psycho guy that shot the gang leader. There's this part in this movie where I think he steals a newspaper or a candy bar or something. And the newspaper lady goes like, hey, aren't you going to pay for that? And he freaks out and goes like, for what?
Hey, what about the money you owe?
For what?
I laugh every time at that. Then he has the bottles on his fingers. He's like, Warriors, come out and play. So that's as much as I'm going to say about the plot. This is an awesome sci-fi post-apocalyptic gang turf movie. It's classic. If you haven't seen it, check it out. I give this one 4.5 out of 5 stars. That's The Warriors. Alright, you guys, this is Danny B. You're watching The Trash Dish. Let me know what you think of The Warriors. Hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. Peace out.